Hey guys, Metal Jesus here, and today we're going to be taking a look at me playing through Forza Horizon 5. Specifically, I'm going to be taking on the Colossus Race. I believe this is probably two-thirds of the way through the game, but what's cool about this one is that this race right here is 12 miles long. I believe that works out to be 19 kilometers, I'm kind of guessing there, but basically what's cool about this is that it is all one long road race, and it shows really well just the beauty and the spectacle that is Forza Horizon 5. Now, this is technically not the longest race in the game. The longest race is called the Goliath, and that one is, what is it, like 33 miles long or something like that? It's massive. And I actually went, I've done that race, and I actually went back to try to capture the footage with it, but the game wouldn't let me replay the race for some reason. It's kind of weird. I did everything I could on the menu, but basically it's part of the festival. And once you get further along in the game and you kind of unlock different things, this is almost like a boss battle race. And so you can't go back to it. I assume maybe you should be able to go back to it, once you beat the game or something. I have no idea. But anyways, and so I had the Colossus here, and so this is a really good second place for that. And again, what's cool about this is that it goes through a huge chunk of the map. You're going to see here that it starts off here kind of in almost like farmland, but then it's going to move down to the coast, and we're going to go into a little bit of a desert area and things like that. And so this video is kind of just my thoughts and impressions of playing this game. As you saw, I was what, level 40 something? I forget. But yeah, I've been playing this game for quite a while, and the Lamborghini Aventador is my car of choice here. I actually really like that paint job. And to be fair, actually, I'm playing this on, I think it's easy mode. I think that's what they call it. But what's interesting about this game is that it's got some pretty strong rubber banding going on, and there's been a lot of complaints about this game online where going between normal is almost too hard, because any mistake you make, the computer just seems to magically catch up. And easy is almost a little bit too easy, although you'll see as I go along in this race, there's still some very tense moments here where I screw up a little bit and suddenly the computer is just right there behind me. So it almost needs like a middle difficulty. It needs something between easy and actually normal. Something that just feels a little bit more fair, like maybe the computer could screw up or something like that. But yeah, I absolutely love this game. It's funny because I don't really get into the hardcore Forza Motorsports series, primarily because I just don't find the tracks very interesting. You know, those are definitely more circuit tracks, just going in circles, things like that, which I get. You know, that's definitely a challenge. But this, to me, is just so amazing how this entire huge section of, it's basically Mexico. They've kind of just taken bits and pieces of Mexico and kind of jammed them together in this one huge map. But I mean, you can go completely off-road here and just kind of make your way through it and explore it. As a matter of fact, that's one of my favorite things to do in this game is, while these kind of races are really fun, I am absolutely addicted to the barn finds. Barn finds are where a computer will call you in and say, hey, we think that there is a barn out in this huge section of the map. And you go out there and you just basically try to find a car that's rusting in an old barn. And once you do, they repair it and then you get it as a drivable car. And so it has a little bit of a collectability thing going on here, which I find really fun. And each of these cars that you get drive vastly, radically different from one another. That's one of the things I think that they pick up from the main Forza Motorsports series, is that the modeling of the different cars is just really cool. You know, but the reason why I like the Aventador here is because it's fast. Also, it's all-wheel drive, and I think even with this Lamborghini, this Lamborghini actually has it where the back wheels actually turn in a little bit. So it's a very fast, almost too easy car to drive. I mean, it goes super fast. That's the thing about it. So you really like when I'm racing on this, I am right on both the gas and the brake all the time in this thing, because it just goes so fast. You just kind of have to try to keep it on the road. You know, it's pretty cool. But as you see, we're cruising through the map here, and I love how it just goes through, you know, a little town. And you can, in the normal game, you can stop and kind of fart around and kind of look. Also, too, I noticed that around Christmas time, the game had, like, Christmas lights and stuff, which, again, I thought was pretty neat. It's almost like a living, breathing world. The other thing that you're not seeing here, speaking of which, is that you're not seeing any other players. I think that's because I am doing a normal race here, part of the story. But normally when you play this game, if you're just kind of bombing around the countryside or whatever, if you're online and you're connected to Xbox Live, you will see a bunch of other racers that show up in your game. And I have to say, it's... Oh, there, I just screwed up. See, but look at that. The computer is not far behind me. Like, if you look on the map there, they almost caught up to me. So, now, I could have rewound time. That's the mechanic that this game kind of promotes. But... I don't do that very often unless I really screw things up. I much prefer a more organic kind of race where, hey, if I screw up, can I recover? You know? Anyways, getting back to the kind of multiplayer or online aspect of this game, I feel like they do it really well, where essentially there's a bunch of options. You don't have to have other people appear in your game world. But I do like the fact that normally when you play this game, it does feel like a living, breathing map, and you'll see other characters driving around. And what's cool about it is that they don't necessarily have to interrupt what you're doing. So, for instance, you know, because very easily I think that could become annoying where people try to smash into you or something. That could be fun too, but essentially they're just like ghost cars, and so you'll see them. But what's cool is that you can interact with them. And again, I'm not going to show that in this video because I'm racing, but... you can suddenly drive up next to somebody and kind of do some donuts around them and interact with them a little bit and kind of cruise around with them and also do some challenges too. And so one time I was playing this game, there was another character, another live driver that was also on it. And we were, you know, I didn't know them. And then we were just kind of cruising around, and we started a challenge where we're in this like little town. And the challenge was suddenly created for us that you had to try to do as many drifts through the streets of this town as quickly as possible. I think it was for like 6 or 8 minutes or something like that. And so he and I were basically just bombing around trying to drift as much as possible during this time. And it was pretty fun. I could see where that would be very addictive. It kind of reminded me of Journey a little bit. Where if you've ever played Journey on the PlayStation, you know, where suddenly other characters would show up, and then before you know it, you're kind of just cruising around, hanging out with them, and it didn't feel annoying. Neither of us had our headsets on, and so, you know, you didn't have to deal with someone yelling or screaming in the background or anything like that. You were just two pure race car drivers cruising around in this massive map. And again, we're about halfway through this race. Look at this. And it's still... It's amazing the technology here, where it's just basically streaming this off of in real time. It's super impressive. Now, one thing I want to mention and talk about in these kind of games, though, is that, you know, this game is considered to be an arcade style racing game. And I would say, yes, that's mostly true, right? Like the fact that you can kind of drive these cars unrealistically. Yes, there's a little bit of scratching damage on it, but, you know, for the most part, it's not necessarily realistic. However, when you compare this to, say, a game like Burnout or, Cruisin' Blast or some of these newer arcade, well, not newer in Burnout's case, but, you know, pure arcade racing games, The big difference, in my opinion, is the weight of the car. So, for instance, you saw just there where I slid into the guardrail. And, you know, if you were playing a Burnout game or something like that, that wouldn't happen, right? Is that there isn't really the sense of weight to these cars. And I think that, and it'd be interesting to talk to a developer, but I think that the way that they really manage that is that they basically just put a little bit of delay or latency on the feel of the controller, meaning that when you start to turn, the game kind of waits for a second for you to turn into it, depending on the speed and maybe, you know, how the car is. But essentially, you know, if you compare it to like a pure arcade racing game where if you turn left or right, the car just like immediately darts that direction, almost as if it weighed nothing. And so I feel like the games like this, the way that they kind of make that balance is by adding a little bit of delay to your controls. Does that make sense? And the reason why I bring that up is because it would be really neat if the developers of this game would give you a 100% pure arcade version of this, where the car just acted like it only weighed like 100 pounds, and you could just do super tight turns at incredibly ludicrous speeds. You know, turning this into an absolute just arcade style game. And on the same side of that, also just make the computer cars the same way. It would be really interesting for them to do that, I think, to just give people the option. Now, maybe that wouldn't work in the online, you know, because then that would be much easier for some people to play the game. But I don't know. I mean, I think that would be pretty fun to do. It'd be almost like turning this into another version of Burnout Paradise or something like that. I think that would be a pretty neat option for them to add, or maybe even do a spin-off version of it where it's just super arcadey. I should probably also mention that this is running on an Xbox Series X console. So this is the top of the line, Xbox machine, and it's running at 4K. And as you see here, it's running it very, very well. There's another example of the computer almost catching up to me. So again, I'm playing this game pretty well, right? And all of a sudden the computer is just there. And so, and again, this is on the easiest setting. So this is not an easy game by any means. I mean, or maybe I'm just not very good at it, but I play a lot of these kind of games, so I feel like I'm okay, you know. But yeah, just an absolutely beautiful, breathtaking game, don't you think? I mean, it feels next gen for sure. It just feels like, wow, like, I don't know, this is pretty amazing. The other thing that this game does, which I kind of want to mention too, is that, and it's new in this version of it, is localized weather. So, you know, in previous games, they would have weather kind of be a pattern that covered the entire map, which makes sense, right? So like if it's a sunny day, well, it's sunny everywhere. If it's raining, it's raining everywhere. But in this one, which is really interesting, because I think the map is so big, it's trying to essentially model an entire country, that you can start off in rain, but then you'll see sunshine off on in the distance and you'll move over into that weather pattern. Or what's really cool is you'll see dust storms that will show up, or you'll see them off in the distance as you're heading towards like the deserty kind of drier area. And then you'll get there and then suddenly you're in a massive snow or a sandstorm, you know, with like really low visibility. It's all of a sudden like really orange out. And I thought that's a pretty neat little feature of this. Again, it makes sense. I'm sure that's not very easy to do, where they'd have, you know, certain sections and it kind of moves around and it changes all the time. So it's very neat. And so as you see here, we've now moved into a little bit more of the deserty part of the Mexico area. The other thing I want to mention too is that I do like this game, or I guess I like the map for sure more than I did the last one, which was set in England. For me personally, it's just, I think the England was a little bit too close to home. You know, I live in Seattle and the look of it and specifically the weather of it was just something I'm very familiar with. I've never been to England, but I assume, you know, based on the game and stuff like that. And I guess my point is that what I like about this is that, and what I like about a lot of these kind of games is the travel element of it. Like, while I'm racing here, it is really fun in these games to just kind of hop in another car, you know, like a truck or a 1960s coupe or something like that, and just kind of cruise around and visit it almost as if I'm traveling. And so I've never been to Mexico. I'd love to go to Mexico. And so I think that's why I like this one a little bit more, because I find it a little bit more interesting for me to drive through. It also, too, I believe, was it Forza 3 that was in Australia? And I really like that one for the exact same reason. Again, just going to another place that is different from where I'm from is very exciting. And one of the appeals of these kind of games, for sure, you know, I'm sure that they know that when building this, is that, okay, where are we going to go? I think that's why a lot of cars or racing games in the past, like Test Drive Unlimited, you know, that was a version of Hawaii for that exact reason, right? Like, most of us don't live in that kind of paradise, and it's really fun to get in an exotic sports car and go someplace that, you know, you haven't been before, right? That's part of the appeal. And so I am approaching the end of this race, and as you can see, I'm doing very well. So again, you know, a couple times in this game, it's sort of prompting me. It's like, hey, you appear to be winning too much. Would you like to dial the difficulty up a little bit? And every single time I do that, then I lose all the time, which is so frustrating. So I'm not entirely sure if there's just like another option that I could check, because I you know, I am winning this fairly easily. Although, you know, again, I do play a lot of these games, and I'm racing okay. But it is one of those things where I'm like, oh man, there needs to be just a midway point, because I do like it whenever somebody's right on my tail, pushing me just to race a little bit harder, you know. But then again, they do seem to catch up pretty quickly. But yeah, so this is Forza Horizon 5. This is the Colossus Race. This is the second longest race in the game. I will say that if you get this game, definitely check out the Goliath, because that one is a completely different race. But it does go the entire length of the Mexico map. You go into some really pretty canyons and stuff like that. It's a really fun race. Although it's funny because it's so long that, like, this one right here is going to wrap up at about, I don't know, 18 minutes or so. That one is a solid half an hour. And it's interesting because at about halfway through, my eyes were glazing, man. It's like, you know, it's so much concentration that towards the end of it, I think I was just like zoning out big time. It was actually pretty funny. And then, you know, towards the end of it, I'm just like, oh my God, like you're concentrating so much that your eyes just kind of glaze over, you know. It's pretty cool. So yeah, there is number one. And the game is, you see that the game is matching close. Oh, I was driving the Centenario. Okay, sorry about that. I thought it was the Aventador. All these new Lamborghini models. But yeah, definitely a really fun game. If you are playing this game and you want to race against me or just hang out too, you saw my gamer tag there. It's MetalJesusRocks. Pretty easy. Hit me up. So, all right, guys. Well, thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing, and take care.